Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, amma ba'd, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, how you guys doing? And today, welcome to another episode where we're going to discuss a major event that would happen after the Battle of Ahzab, or the Battle of Khandaq, and before the Treaty of Hudaybiyah. Now we're going to talk about another major controversy that happened in the life of the Prophet, peace be upon him's life. Last week, we discussed what? The invasion of Banu Qurayza. Today we're going to talk about the Prophet, peace upon him's marriage to Zainab. And next week, inshallah, we're going to put all the other events together in one episode called the major events that would happen between Ahzab, Khandaq, and Hudaybiyah, discussing the other events that would happen. However, we're going to single out this episode because it's very, very important and because it's a major controversy that is set upon the Prophet, peace upon him, and we have to give it justice and we have to speak about it. Now, my goal, inshallah, in this explanation of the Prophet's marriage to Zainab and the controversy on it is to make it clear to you. And if anyone was to bring this up to you later on, you can already have knowledge of this event in your head and be able to answer them. And for you, know that there is no negativity or evil upon the Prophet's name or status or honor. Now, please try to keep up with me as I understand this may seem a little complex as I'm discussing exactly what I'm going to be discussing. But please try to keep up with me and inshallah it makes sense. And inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it understandable for you. Okay, first, who is Zainab binti Jahash? Zainab binti Jahash is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's first cousin. In fact, Zainab's mom and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's dad are brothers and sisters. So they are first cousins. Point one. Point two, Zainab, she was 15 years younger than the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, who was Zainab before? She was married to a Qurashi, a Quraysh man, someone from Mecca. She divorced him. Then she migrated to Medina. In Medina, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would arrange a marriage between Zainab bint Jahash and Zaid bin Haritha. Who is Zaid bin Haritha? Remember, we talked about him so long ago. Maybe throughout this episode we'll discuss who exactly Zaid bin Haritha is. This is the marriage that he would put together. Zainab and Zaid bin Haritha. Now the Prophet went to Zainab and her brother and proposed this marriage to them. Is that the Prophet is encouraging them or recommending Zaid bin Haritha for Zainab bint Jahash. At first, Zainab, she didn't want this marriage. She was, too hesitant in it. However, after Prophet kept encouraging her and recommending Zaid for her, she finally accepted. Now, in this marriage, Zainab and Zaid, it was just, a mismatch or something happened or, it wasn't a good marriage. So it led to a divorce. However, during the marriage, every time there would be a fight or a, something happening, Zaid bin Haritha would always go to the Prophet upon him and the Prophet upon him would say what? He would try to reconcile, make the marriage better and tell him, go back to your wife, keep your wife and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Zaid would go temporarily. However, later it would lead to their divorce. Zainab and Zaid would no longer be husband and wife, and they would be divorced. Now, what happens after all this is that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam marries Zainab bint Jahash. This is the story. Now, where is the controversy? What's the purpose of the Prophet upon him marrying Zainab bint Jahash? What happened? Why are people talking negativity about this? We're going to discuss today. First and foremost is, who is Zaid bin Haritha? Zaid bin Haritha, as we discussed so long ago, he's also known as Zaid bin Muhammad, meaning that he is the adopted son of the Prophet upon him. And the Quraysh, or the people of Mecca, or even the people in Arabia, viewed adopted son the same as a blood son. So we're going to see clearly from this story is that there's a difference between the two in Islam. Okay, so why would the Prophet upon him marry her? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in the Quran, in Surah Al-Ahzab, Ayah 37, and this is really the only true stuff that we know 100% happened. Later on, we're going to discuss a story from the books of Seerah, many books of Seerah. We're going to discuss exactly how that is. However, those stories are not authentic. However, of course, the Quran is 100% reliable and we can trust it. So we're going to see exactly what is said. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the 37th verse in Surah Al-Ahzab, and remember, O Muhammad, when you said to the one whom Allah bestowed favor and you bestowed favor. Talking about who? Zaid bin Haritha. Anyways, even later on this verse, subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions Zaid bin Haritha by name. The only Sahabi ever mentioned by name in the Quran is Zaid bin Haritha in this verse. Anyways, so we're discussing, we're talking about Zaid. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, remember when he came to you and he said what? And you said to him, keep your wife and fear Allah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues says, while you concealed what was in your heart, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was going to discuss exactly what this means. And you feared the people while Allah has more right for you to fear. So when Zayd no longer had any need for her, we married her to you in order that there be no discomfort upon the believers concerning marrying the wives of their adopted sons. Pause. Let's talk about this verse so we can understand exactly what's happening. So we're talking about Zayd bin Haritha. And exactly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying when he used to come to the Prophet upon him, and the Prophet upon him used to say what? Keep your wife and do not divorce her and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? We understand this part. Now, while you concealed what was in your heart. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, when the Prophet peace upon him said, keep your wife and fear Allah, he had something in his heart that he did not say. What was this that he disclosed in his heart? We're going to discuss later on. Now, the reason why the Prophet peace upon him disclosed this, and we'll discuss exactly what he disclosed, is because he feared what the people would say, rather than, although he should have feared what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Pause for a second. Don't ever even think that this is a sin upon the Prophet upon him, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't say in this verse that it's a sin, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not in this verse in any way refer to tawbah, repentance, or forgiveness of the Prophet upon him, or he had to seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyways, so this is exactly what happened. Then we mentioned what? That when Zayd no longer needed her, meaning when Zayd divorced her, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala married Zainab to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay? So this is the most unique of marriages. Even the marriage is present with us today. You know, the nikah, the marriage contract is present with us today. It's right here in Surah Ahzab, verse 37. Anyways, the reason for this marriage was what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers it in the verse. Is so that there cannot be any discomfort upon the believers, meaning me and you, concerning marrying the wives of our adopted sons. So in Islam, what? It's clearly making the distinction between an adopted son and a blood son. For example, just very quickly, if I had a blood son and he married and, you know, they divorced or my son died or whatever happened, I can never marry my son, blood son's wife, because she becomes a mahram. I'm a mahram of her, rather. And I can never marry her, right? However, my adopted son, since he's not my blood son, takes a whole different ruling, a whole different fiqhi ruling, a jurisprudence ruling. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making this clear in Islam that we do not have or make this similarity between a blood son and an adopted son. And this is something, as I mentioned, I'm going to mention, is that the Quraysh did do. They viewed these two people as the same. This is why Zayd was also known as Zayd bin Muhammad, even though he was not bin Muhammad, right? Okay, now, we said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he married them, and this is what happened. Okay, where's the controversy? Now, the controversy comes from, of course, the marriage of the adopted son, but that's not where the major controversy comes. The major controversy comes is in a story not mentioned in the Quran, however mentioned in the books of Seerah. Now, the only reason why we're going to discuss this, or this has any precedence upon us, or any, you know, concern upon us, the Muslims, is because it's mentioned in many, in fact, maybe even all, of the original early Seerah books, from Ibn Sa'd, from, you know, all the tafsir referring to this verse, the early ones, At-Tabari, everyone mentions the story that I'm going to mention. However, another group of scholars, another group, you know, serious, legitimate scholars, like Ibn Kathir and Ibn Hajar, they mention another story that would happen. However, both of these stories are not 100% authentic, are not 100% reliable, are not something that I have to take as fact. However, we're going to take them as fact for the sake of argument to see that even by taking these two stories that the people of the people today criticize the Prophet upon him, even if we were to take that stance, it does not bring any negativity upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at all. So we're going to mention two versions of the story and two interpretations of this one story. And once again, please try to stay focused and understanding of what I'm going to say, because it can get confusing as we're going to get technical. Now, what is the story? The story is that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam one day went to Zayd bin Haritha's house. And this is when Zayd and Zainab were married, okay? When the Prophet, peace upon him, arrived there, Zayd was not home. So Zainab came and opened the door. Now, it is even mentioned by some that Zainab was wearing a dress, okay? She opened the door and she told him that Zayd is not here. So then the Prophet, peace upon him, was going to leave, but Zainab said, what? Please come in. You know, she invited him inside. However, the Prophet, peace upon him, didn't go inside, and he left mumbling something. The thing that he mumbled was, "All praise due to Allah, the one who changes the hearts." Okay, the Prophet peace be upon him left. Zayd bin Haritha, he comes home. And he tells, Zainab tells him about the Prophet peace be upon him visited, and you weren't home, and I tried to invite him. However, he left and didn't accept my invitation, mumbling something. Zayd said, what was he mumbling? She told him what he was mumbling, and Zayd understood something by this statement, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes the hearts. And from that, he went, this was like the final straw for him. He went to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, I want to divorce Zainab. And the Prophet peace be upon him said, what? As mentioned in the Quran, keep your wife and fear Allah. And when the Prophet, peace be upon him, said this, he disclosed something in his heart. Okay? And the reason why he disclosed this thing in his heart, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the verse, is because he feared what the people would say. We're going to discuss exactly what he disclosed in the heart and exactly what it meant later on. But this is what happened. The Prophet, peace be upon him, kept trying to reconcile and improve this marriage. However, Zayd, he just couldn't take it anymore. So he divorced Zainab. And like we said, the marriage wasn't, you know, the ideal marriage, unfortunately. So it led to a divorce. When this divorce happened, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what? After the iddah, I don't know if we mentioned the iddah in this verse, but we did mention in the seerah what iddah is. The period after marriage that a woman has to wait before she gets married again. After the iddah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals this verse that we mentioned in Surah Ahzab, Ayah 37, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala married Zainab to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the nikah is there. Now when this nikah was there, the Prophet now is the husband of Zainab binti Jahash. Now, let's pause for a second and let's talk about where the controversy comes in and where are the two interpretations or the two versions of the story and how can we understand it and make the most of it. Version A says that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he visited Aisha, when he visited Zainab, he became physically attracted. He physically wanted Zainab because he seen her at the door for whatever reason. He wanted her at that moment. And when he said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes what's in the heart, it may refer to what? That he now lusts or wants Zainab. So Zayd bin Haritha, being someone who loves the Prophet so much, after he thought or interpreted that this means the Prophet wants to marry Zainab or he loves Zainab, I cannot be married to her anymore, so I have to divorce her. So what? I'm going to divorce her and the Prophet can marry her. This is what their interpretation says. So the thing that the Prophet concealed in his heart was his love for Aisha. Love for Zainab. Okay? This is number one. Now, where is this a controversy? Is because we said the Quraysh, and even people today say this, is that the Prophet upon him, he loved or he had this lust for his adopted son's daughter. Look at this. Why is this? This is so evil, so on and so forth. But we immediately see, even though the scholars of Seerah clearly said this and mentioned the story, we see that it cannot be entirely true because of many reasons. One reason is, let's pause and look at this first story, is that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as we mentioned in the beginning, he and Zainab are what? First cousins. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's not logical that at this moment, for whatever reason, he became attracted to Zainab for no reason and now he began to love her. Rather, if he loved her, if he was attracted by her looks, he would have seen her looks many times before. So he would have been attracted to her in the beginning, right? So it cannot make sense because of this. We cannot say, oh, at this moment, he's seen Zainab. No, she was his cousin, so he always used to see her. So some people may say, oh, it's not because he's seen her, you know, just seen her physically. He's seen her many times. But maybe because he's seen her, as you mentioned, Ahmed, seen her in a dress. She wasn't wearing hijab. Well, now we have to take this story into context. When did this story happen? Brothers and sisters, when this story happened, the verses of hijab were not revealed, meaning a woman in Islam did not have to wear hijab. So the Prophet used to see Zainab, and the Muslims used to see Zainab, and everyone used to see each other as normal, because the verses of hijab were not revealed yet. In fact, fun fact, the verses of hijab weren't revealed until the night of the wedding of Zainab and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay? So we clearly see that this cannot be true. So some people may say, what after all this? Oh, maybe the attraction was always there. Maybe he's seen her from the beginning and he loved her body. Maybe the attraction was always there. This cannot make sense. Why? Is because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what did he do? He himself married Zainab and Zayd together. Why would he put forth this marriage? Why would he arrange this marriage if he had feelings towards Zainab? He could have just married her from the beginning and she would have accepted and we have none of this story, none of this problems for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why would he put this marriage together if this was true? Correct? It does not make sense. It does not make any for us to think. It has some itchiness to it. Anyways, Then we have another thing that people will say. The Prophet Muhammad, he loved Zainab binti Jahash. So why did this happen? This is why the Prophet Muhammad wanted or introduced or he put the idea in Zayd's head that he wanted to divorce her is because he loved her and he wanted her. However, this does not make sense because what I mentioned many times that Zayd bin Haritha and Zainab, they had problems in their relationship, correct? So why would the Prophet Muhammad, as mentioned in the Quran and mentioned many times in the Seerah, is that he would try to reconcile this marriage. He would try to make this marriage work. Why would he do this? Why would he not try to make it, you know, divorce in the beginning? So this is version one, and we see clearly why it has some problematic when we think about it. And we really discuss and analyze exactly what is being said about this story. So just to summarize and to understand that this cannot be true, and the thing that the Prophet was concealing as per this opinion or this view is his love for Zainab, and we've clearly seen why this cannot be true according to the situation and the circumstances. Then we have version two, which I personally lean towards. Now, when we understand just one thing, what was the Prophet Muhammad, he himself concealing in his heart or disclosing in his heart, it makes sense exactly and it fits perfectly and it just makes sense. So version 2 says that the thing that the Prophet Muhammad was concealing in his heart was what? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had previously, whatever moment it was, had disclosed that Muhammad would eventually marry Zainab. Now, when the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ heard this, or when he received this news, he became shy. He didn't want this to happen because of exactly what was said in the verse, exactly what we said many times before, because of the idea of marrying your adopted son's wife. So what happened is that Muhammad ﷺ, when Zayd found out that the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, you know, said this and whatever interpretation it had because of this, he went towards the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ and he tried to get the divorce, but the Prophet ﷺ didn't want. He told Zayd bin Haritha to keep your wife because he knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was going to marry him, and he didn't want this to happen because he was following this idea that is a taboo or something that is not accepted in that society. However, we cannot say that the Prophet Muhammad was shy because if we were to take version 2, which makes more sense, that the Prophet, the only thing that he was disclosing at that point is that he knew that he was going to marry Zainab eventually. However, he didn't want this to happen because of the things that we mentioned before. We cannot say that the Prophet Muhammad is shy or is trying to deny the qadr of Allah, the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, he had human emotion, human feelings towards this. However, we also know is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that we have married Zainab to you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accepted this fully. And in fact, his wedding, his walima, was the biggest walima that he had with any of his wives. In fact, we have many narrations about the wedding between Prophet Muhammad and Zainab. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did decree this final decision, khalas, that's it, the Prophet Muhammad accepted this and he went by this and he, you know, was proudly showing that he was married to Zainab. And we have the idea now complete that in Islam, an adopted son and a regular son is not the same. This is the story, and we see, inshallah, we understood it in some way, and how this is not a controversy, and how this is not something that's problematic at all when we really look at it and really understand it. Just quick notes about Zainab herself. She was one of the greatest wives of the Prophet Muhammad. Even in fact, we have many narrations from many of the Sahaba saying about Zainab how she used to always give in charity. In fact, she was the most generous of the wives of the Prophet Muhammad. And Aisha herself says this in a hadith. She says, I have never seen any woman more righteous than her, and more fearing of Allah and truthful in speech than her, and more caring for her family, and more generous in charity, and more energizing in her efforts to come closer to Allah than Zainab binti Jahash. So this is who Zainab binti Jahash is. Now we understand the story. Now we understand the view of it. So anytime, inshallah, this happens, whenever it happens, if someone brings up the story to us, we clearly have the idea in our heads that yes, we know that story A or story B is mentioned in many books of Seerah, that both, you know, many scholars agree with this one or that one. However, now we understand, you know, using our brains, that one makes more sense than the other because of other determining factors when we put them into play. But the main thing is not so which one is right, which one is wrong, just to show you that even if we were to look at the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's life, in whatever aspect, in detail or in general, we always see that the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never did anything evil, never has any negativity on his honor or his status or his persona, if you want. And we just need to learn these incidents and know these ideas so that we can understand who the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is and really strengthen our knowledge of who he is. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you guys for watching. And this is, inshallah, another victory for us, me and you, that we understood another controversy amongst many of the people. For example, the invasion of Banu Qurayza, the marriage to Zainab, you know, the expulsion of many other Jewish tribes in Medina, all these other misconceptions in the seerah. Alhamdulillah, we have mastered and we have completed all of them and understood them fully. Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us on this. What is upon us is to continue this. So inshallah, next week we're going to discuss other major events that happened between Khandaq, Ahzab and Hudaybiyah, and we're going to further our study in the seerah and make sure we stay upon this and we encourage ourselves and our friends and our family and everyone who knows the seerah and wants to learn the seerah to actually learn this and actually learn these stories so that we can become better Muslims and so that we can understand what Islam is, what the verses of the Quran are being revealed to, and who the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was, and how in any situation he is always the best of people and a great example and great role model for everyone. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. See you guys next week.